Hi all, my name is Josh Livney and I work on the developer relations team here at Google. Today I want to show you how to add a new dimension to your map by integrating Google Earth in just four lines of code. First, let's take a look at a basic Maps API example that we'd like to add a 3D view to. Here I have a basic map that I've taken from the Maps v3 examples page, which has a simple KML layer. I've replaced the KML overlay of the Chicago Transit with this track of my snowboard route from Squaw Valley last weekend, which I recorded and shared using the MyTracks application on Android. It's been a bad year at the Sierras. Not much fresh snow. Can you tell if I stuck to the groomers in these conditions? Not really, because even with the satellite view enabled, it's hard to get a feel for the mountain. So let's edit the code here to first include the generic Google API loader, which we'll do in this script tag. For those of you familiar with Earth API development, you'll note that I have not specified a domain-specific API key in the loader, and this is because since the launch last year of Google Earth version 6, the API key has not been required. Next, we'll load up the third-party utility library that takes care of the Maps and Earth integration. I'm loading a local copy, and there's a link to the library at the end of the presentation. And now, let's load up the Earth API itself, which we do by simply calling google.load, Earth, and then the version 1. The Google Loader, by the way, can also load up a variety of other APIs, as well as hosted libraries like jQuery. Check it out at developers.google.com/loader. Okay, moving on now. With three of our four lines already done, let's finally add that Earth button to our mashup. I'll do this down at the end of our existing code by instantiating a new Google Earth object and passing it the map instance we want to associate it with. So let's refresh our map. And look, we have an Earth button at the top right in the controls, and clicking it will load up the Earth API, which, as you can see, gives a much nicer context to these tracks. Let's make these tracks seem a bit more impressive. This bit takes advantage of the fact that you can control the full experience of the Earth API using the handler the Google Earth library returns. Here, for example, I've modified the terrain exaggeration programmatically. But you could also turn on the historical imagery and generally take full advantage of all the powerful features of Google Earth to help ensure your map tells the story the way you want. Currently, this Maps Earth integration library supports all the basic overlays, including markers, polylines, polygons, circles, rectangles, and, of course, KML. So that's it for the intro to quickly bringing Google Earth to your Maps v3 application. If you have some data that could use the rich context of a 3D view, this library is a simple way to get started. Have fun!